Welcome to Homeopathic Pharmacy Academy. In this video lecture, I am going to explain about the preparation of drugs in homeopathy. So the drug means it is a pharmaceutically prepared substance according to the techniques of homeopathic pharmacy. From the various drug substances or raw materials, and it is capable of affecting the sensations and functions of the body. Another concept is medicine, where these medicines are the drugs which are potentized and it is proved on healthy human beings. The difference between a drug and a medicine in homeopathic pharmacy is the drug is in its crude state, whereas medicine is the potentized form and which is prepared from the drug itself. Another concept is remedy, where a medicine is indicated for a particular patient depending on symptom similarity. Then that medicine is called remedy. So this is the basic definitions of drug, medicine and remedy. And now we are going to discuss about the preparation of drugs, that is the crude form. So in homeopathy, the term drug indicates three forms of the medicines. That is the mother tincture, mother solution, and mother substances. Now let us see what is mother tincture, mother solution, and mother substance. Mother tincture, it is denoted by a letter Q. It is a hydroalcoholic solution pharmaceutically prepared from a drug substance of plant or animal origin by the process of extraction using a soluble vehicle in a definite proportion as per pharmacopoeia. So it is a hydroalcoholic solution. That means it contains water and alcohol as a solvent, and it is prepared by the process of extraction. So it is extracted from a drug substance, that is a raw material of plant or animal origin, in a definite proportion as per pharmacopoeia. So this is a definition of mother tincture, and it is denoted by the letter Q. Another form of drug is mother solution. So here it is denoted as Q sol. The mother solution is denoted as Q sol. It is a homogeneous substance or a homogeneous mixture of drug substance and a suitable vehicle or solvent. So here the suitable vehicle or solvent means it can be either alcohol or purified water, prepared by the process of dissolving it in a definite proportion as per pharmacopoeia. So it is nothing but it is only a homogeneous mixture. So what do you mean by homogeneous mixture? So a substance, the drug substance and the vehicle should be properly dissolved without any residue. And we cannot separate out these drug substance and the solvent in this solution. So that type of mixture is known as homogeneous mixture. So here the solvent used is alcohol or purified water, and it is prepared by dissolving this drug substance in this suitable or appropriate solvent by the process of dissolving in a definite proportion. Now the next form of drug in homeopathic pharmacy is mother substance or mother powder, which is denoted by zero or O. It is a dry or solid mixture pharmaceutically prepared from a drug substance by trituration with a vehicle like sugarcane milk in a definite proportion as per pharmacopoeia. So there are drug substances which cannot be extracted with alcohol and water mixture, or cannot be dissolved in alcohol or purified water. So such drug substances are insoluble in liquid solvents. So such a drug substance should be triturated, or it should be grinded with a vehicle like sugarcane milk with the help of mortar and pestle in a definite proportion as per pharmacopoeia. So mother substance is prepared from the insoluble drug substance, and it should be grinded with sugarcane milk. Now there are some other forms of preparations like extraction. So it is a process by which a medicinally active portion of plant or animal tissue are separated from inactive or inert component by using selective solvents. So extraction can be done in different ways. In homeopathic pharmacy, we are using several methods of extractions, like a simple maceration or percolation or hot percolation, cold percolation, then Soxhlet extraction method, continuous hot extraction method. There are different types of extraction method prevailed, and we use a definite method according to the drug substance. Now let us see menstruum. Menstruum is nothing but it is a solvent used for the extraction. So extraction is employed for a crude drug to obtain the therapeutically desirable portion and eliminate inert material by treating it with a selective solvent, and that is known as menstruum. So menstruum is nothing but it is a selective solvent. It's not merely a solvent, but a selective solvent. Here the term selective solvent means it is selective for a particular drug substance. So not all the solvent can able to extract all the active principles or active constituents from a particular drug substance. So that depends. So a selective solvent is opted to make a particular extract from a particular crude drug substance. And it has a capacity to penetrate animal or plant tissue and extract active constituents which is present inside by dissolving them. So menstruum can be a single vehicle or a solvent, or it can be mixture of different solvents like alcohol, water, or glycerin, or any other types of solvents. Now another word is magma. Magma is a thick residue of soft doughy mass or a molten mass resulting from the pounding of fresh plant. That means before the preparation of drug, the drug substance are made into pulp form. So that is called as soft doughty mass or molten mass. So that is the thick one. So whenever you want to make a drug or an extract from a drug substance of plant origin or animal origin, we have to make it into a pulp form. So that is known as magma. Now another one is murk. Murk is the inert fibrous or insoluble substances remaining after expression of juice from the drug material or after maceration or percolation. So here, whatever is the residue left behind, or any type of inert substances, any type of fibrous or insoluble residue remaining after the extraction of or expression of the juice from the drug substance, that is called as murk. So here magma is the form of drug substance before the preparation of extract or mother tincture or whatever it may be. But murk is whatever the residue left behind after the extraction or expression of the juice from the drug substance. Now another term is digestion. It is a form of maceration in which gentle heat is used during the process of extraction. So if the extraction is carried out by using a gentle heat, or once the drug substance is heated and the extraction process is carried out, then it is called as digestion. Now another term used is infusion. Infusion is nothing but it is a dilute solution of readily soluble constituent of a crude drug. A fresh infusion is prepared by macerating drug for a short period of time with either cold or boiled water as menstruum. So this is like how a coffee is made. So how a coffee is made, to a boiled water, the coffee powder is inserted, or we put the coffee powder in a boiled water, we make coffee. So the similar techniques is used to make a drug or extraction using infusion method. Now another term is decoction. Decoction is an extraction of water soluble and heat soluble constituents from a crude drug by boiling in water for 15 minutes and cooling and straining it. It is used for hard and crude drugs. So here the decoction, the extraction is made by boiling the drug substance in the water for a considerably long period of time, 15 minutes. Then after that, it should be cooled and it should be strained out. And this is especially used in a very hard and crude drug substance, which cannot be extracted by a digestion method or infusion method. So here the difference between infusion and decoction is, in infusion we are mixing the drug substance in a previously boiled water or boiling water, whereas in decoction we are keep on boiling the water for about 15 minutes along with the drug substance. So decoction is not suited for a heat resistible constituents or heat liable constituents. Suppose if heat deteriorate the constituents, we cannot employ decoction because we are boiling it for a long time. Whereas such drug substance we can make either by infusion method or by digestion method. So this is about the various methods of extraction. Now let us see what are the vehicles used in the preparation of drug in homeopathic pharmacy. Alcohol, water, glycerin, and sugar of milk. So these are the various vehicles which are used in the preparation formulation of mother preparations. It can be mother tinctures, mother solution, and mother substances. Now let us see the classification of drug preparations in homeopathy. So there are two methods. Basically, there are two methods of drug preparations. The one is old classical Hahnemannian method, and another one is new or modern method. So these are the methods used for drug preparations. Now, the old classical or Hahnemannian method is a method, as the name implies. It was introduced by Hahnemann himself. But the new method or modern method of drug preparation was introduced by British Homeopathic Pharmacopoeia, and later it was elaborated by Homeopathic Pharmacopoeia of the United States. So these are the differences. Now let us see the first one, that is the old or classical or Hahnemannian method. So this old method, there are three types of or three forms of drugs. As I told earlierly, they are mother tincture, mother solution, and mother substance. So the difference between the old method or Hahnemannian method and new method is, one of the basic difference is, in old method, Hahnemann consider the moisture or water which is present in the plant as a part of the drug. Whereas in new method, it is not considered as a part of drug, but it is considered as a part of solvent or vehicle. And accordingly, the drug strength is calculated. Now, let us see the various forms of drug and its preparation in old or classical or Hahnemannian method. Now let us see, first one is mother tincture. So there are four classes under mother tincture. Hahnemann has classified into four classes under mother tincture. Then mother solution, Hahnemann has classified into two, that is class 4 and class 5 and class 6. And it has got some sub-classification also, like class 5A, class 5B, class 6A, class 6B. And mother substance, again Hahnemann has classified it into 3, that is class 7, class 8, and class 9. So totally there are 9 classes in old method or classical method or Hahnemannian method, and these classifications are made based on the method of preparation. Now let us see how Hahnemann classified the methods of preparation of mother tincture. So mother tincture, Hahnemann classified into 4, that is class 1, class 2, class 3, and class 4. So I told you that Hahnemann has made this classification based on the method and the moisture or water present in the drug substance. So class 1, the plants belongs to most juicy plants. Class 2 is moderately juicy. Class 3 is least juicy. And class 4, it is dried one, dried plant. Or if you use a dried drug substance which belongs to plants or animals, then the method belongs to class 4. Now coming to mother solution, Hahnemann broadly divided into two classes, that is class 5 and class 6. Class 5, the substances mostly from the mineral sources or chemical sources which are soluble in water, and this class is again divided into two, that is class 5A and 5B. So 5A is the substance which are soluble, the drug substance which are soluble in small quantity of water, or the substance which are easily soluble. So if a substance is dissolving in a small quantity of water, that means that substance is very easily soluble. And next subclassification is class 5B. So here the drug substance are soluble in large quantity of water. So these drug substances are sparingly soluble in water, or it require much water to dissolve it. So they are sparingly soluble. Coming to class 6, the solvent used is alcohol, or drug substance which are only soluble in alcohol are classified under class 6. So here also there are two subclassifications or subtypes. Substance which are very easily soluble in small quantity of alcohol are classified into 6A, whereas drug substance which require large quantity of alcohol to dissolve it, that means these drug substances are sparingly soluble in alcohol, such drug substances are classified under class 6B. Now next form of drug is mother substance. I told you these mother substances are neither soluble in water or in alcohol, so it has to be grinded or triturated with sugar of milk with the help of mortar and pestle. So these are classified as in class 7, class 8, class 9. Now let us see what are the difference in this method, class 7, class 8 and class 9. So class 7, the drug substances are dry insoluble substances. So it is dry, that is it is in solid state, but it will not be soluble in alcohol or water. Such drug substance has to be grinded with sugar. Now class 8. Class 8 is a liquid insoluble substances. So these drug substances are in liquid state, but it is insoluble in alcohol and water. So it has to be triturated with sugar of milk with the help of mortar and pestle. Now the last one is class 9. So the class 9, the drug substance used are from fresh vegetable sources or animal sources. So this fresh drug substance has to be triturated with sugar of milk in a definite proportion. So this is a broad classification of old method or classical method or Hahnemannian method. Now let us see these methods in detail. So class 1, I told you the source and nature, it is most juicy plant. Here the drug vehicle ratio is 1:1. That means to every one part of drug substance, one part of vehicle should be used. And there is no residue in this class 1 because it belongs to most juicy plant and we are collecting only the juice as drug substance. So in a juice there may not be a residue, so only without residue the juice is used, so there is no residue in that. And the drug power is 1/2 because we are taking one part of drug substance and one part of vehicle. So the drug power is an actual drug which is present in the medicine, actual drug. So we are taking half the drug. So the drug power is half. Next is the fundamental rule. Fundamental rule means under which drug Hahnemann has mentioned about this particular method of preparation in Metri Medica Pura or chronic diseases. So these are the works done by Hahnemann, and under which drug Hahnemann explained about this particular method. So that is what is called as the fundamental rule. Now the process of potentization, it is prepared by the method of succussion. Once the mother tincture is prepared, the next succeeding potencies, dilutions are prepared by the method of succussion. Now let us see next class, that is class 2, moderately juicy. So it may contain some amount of terpenes or fibers or some insoluble substances. So it contains moderate juice. So here the drug and vehicle ratio is 3:2. That means to every 3 parts of drug substance, 2 part of vehicle is added. And we can expect some 1/3 of residue in class 2 plants. Drug power is 1/2. And the fundamental rule here is Thuja. So under Thuja, Hahnemann explained about class 2 method. And the process of potentization is succussion method. Now class 3, the source and nature of drug substance is, it is least juicy plant because it contains very less amount of juice and residue will be more. So here drug and vehicle ratio is 1:2. To every 1 part of drug substance, double the quantity of vehicle is or alcohol is required to extract. The residue is 2/3 will be the residue. Only 1/3 will be the actual soluble constituents of the drug. The drug power is 1/6. And the fundamental rule is Skilla. The process of potentization is succussion. Now class 4. Class 4, I told you, it is dry substances, that is from vegetable source and animal sources. Here the drug vehicle ratio is 1:5. That is to every 1 part of drug substance, 5 part of vehicle is added. Here the residue will be 1/2. The drug power will be 1/10. That means to every 10 parts of mother tincture, the actual drug will be the 1 part. The 9 part will be the vehicle. Now fundamental rule. This method has been explained under 2 drugs. That is Staphysagria and Spigelia. And the process of potentization is succussion. Now mother solutions. So in mother solutions, class 4, class 5A. So the source and nature, it is from mineral kingdom, which are soluble in small quantity of water, as I told. The drug vehicle ratio is 1:9. That means to every 1 part of drug substance, 9 part of vehicle is added. And naturally the drug power will be 1/10. So that means 1/10 means 1 part will be the drug and 9 part will be the vehicle. And the fundamental rule is natrum muriaticum, and chemically natrum muriaticum is sodium chloride and it is very easily soluble in water. That is why it belongs to class 5A. The method of potentization is succussion. Now class 5B, it also belongs to mineral kingdom. which requires large quantity of water to dissolve. The drug vehicle ratio is 1:99 and the drug power is 1/100. The fundamental rule is acid phosphoricum or phosphoric acid. The method of potentization is succussion. Now next mother solution is class 6A and 6B. 6A from mineral sources, which are soluble in small quantity of alcohol. And these drug substance which belongs to 6 are minerals which are soluble in alcohol only. The drug vehicle ratio is 1:9. The drug power is 1/10. The fundamental rule here is guaiacum. And the method of potentization is succussion. Next one is 6B. It belongs to mineral or some plant and animals, animal sources. Now, these substances, these drug substances are soluble in large quantity of alcohol. And the drug vehicle ratio is 1:99. The drug power is 1/100. The fundamental rule here is Merck corrosiveness or Merck in short. The method of potentization is succussion. Next form of medicine or drug is mother substances. So here class 7, they are dry or solid insoluble substances, which can be from mineral source, sarcodes or no source. So the class 7 is prepared with a ratio 1:9, or it can be prepared with 1:99. So if it is prepared with the ratio 1:9, then it is this ratio is decimal ratio, decimal scale. If it is prepared with 1:99, then it is called as centesimal scale. Centesimal. Here ratio is 1:99. Now the drug power, if it is prepared with the decimal scale, then it is 1/10. If it is prepared with the centesimal scale, then the drug power is 1/100. Now the fundamental rule here, it is arsenicum album, which is mentioned in Mathematica Pura, written by Hahnemann. So under arsenicum album, Hahnemann explained about the class 7. And the succeeding potencies are prepared with the method trituration. Now class 8, the source and nature of drug substance, they are liquid insoluble substances which belongs to minerals, sarcodes or no source. Again, this class 8 is prepared with the two scales, that is decimal scale and centesimal scale. Decimal scale, it is 1:9 and the drug power is 1/10. In centesimal scale, ratio is 1:99, drug power is 1/100. And the fundamental rule in this class is petroleum, which is mentioned in Chronic Diseases by Hahnemann. And method of potentization is by trituration. Now the last class is class 9. The nature and source of drug substance, they are taken from vegetable, fresh vegetable and some animal sources. And here the drug vehicle ratio is in decimal scale, it is 2:9. And in centesimal scale, it is 2:99. But the drug power will be 1/10 and 1/100. So why this difference is, since we are using a fresh drug substance, it may contain some amount of water or moisture. So during the process of trituration, the one part of, we are assuming that one part of drug substance will be evaporated because it contains a lot of water, being a fresh drug substance. So that is why we are taking double the quantity of drug substance. But after the process of trituration or grinding, there remains only one part. That is why in drug power, it is 1 by 10 or 1 by 100. Even though we are taking two parts of drug in preparing drug substance, in the ratio it is 2:9 or 2:99. Now, the fundamental rule here is Agaricus muscaris. That is a fungus, a fresh fungus, and which is given under chronic diseases written by hand. And the method of patentization is by trituration. So this is about the broad view on different classes. Class 1, class 2, class 3, class 4, class 5, A and B, class 6, A and B, then class 7, class 8, class 9. Among this class, class 1 to class 4 is for mother tinctures, class 5 and 6 for mother solutions, and class 7, 8, 9 are for mother substances. Now let us see little more details about these classes. Now class 1, plant in this class contain large quantity of juices, I already told. And these plants are mostly European plants. And what it contains? It contains mostly juicy, but not a viscid juice. And it does not containing resins or terpenes or volatile oil, making it more viscid. And the drug vehicle ratio is 1:1. Juice is taken. And how the medicine is prepared according to class 1. We are extracting only the juice from the drug substance. Since it contains large amount of juice, only juice is taken. And this juice is mixed with equal quantity of alcohol. So that is why the ratio 1:1. And the drug power is 1 by 2. Examples. The fundamental rule, I told you, it is Belladonna. The other drugs which are prepared with class 1 is Aconite, Chamomilla, Chelidonium, Dulcamara, Bryonia Alba, and Calendula. So this is how class 1 is prepared. Now, class 2. Class 2, as I told, it contains moderately juice. Those who are moderately juice plants. So these drug substance or plants contains non-mucilaginous materials, which contains resins, terpenes, or volatile oil. So these substances make it a somewhat viscid juice, and it may contain some amount of residue. Okay. Now, the drug vehicle ratio is 3:2. So every 3 parts of drug substance, 2 part of alcohol is added. Now, how to prepare drugs with class 2? So the pulp is prepared. Once the pulp is prepared, it will be moistened with a sufficient amount of alcohol and keep it for 2 or 3 days. Once it is well mixed with alcohol, after 3 days, this juice is extracted out. This juice is extracted out, and with the filtered juice, the remaining amount of alcohol is added. And this juice and this alcohol is kept for 8 days. And at the end of 8th day, the extract is strained out and it is again filtered. And thus we obtain mother tincture. So the first process is we need to get the pulp of the drug substance. Then it should be moistened with a sufficient amount of alcohol. Keep it with this alcohol for about 2 or 3 days. Once it is properly mixed, the juice is extracted out and filtered. Then the remaining amount of alcohol is added to this juice and kept it for 8 days. And after at the end of 8th day, the juice is again filtered, strained and filtered, and the mother tincture is obtained. And this contains 1/3 of residue. In this residue will be discarded. The drug strength is 1/2. And the fundamental rule of class 2, as I already told, it is Thuja. The other drugs belongs to class 2 is Rustox, Symphytum, Oleander, Euphrasia, Xerium and Tabacum. Now, class 3. Class 3, as I told, it contains least juice and it contains more of residues. And the drug vehicle ratio here is 1:2. That means to every one part of drug substance, double the quantity of alcohol is required. Now, the method of preparation is the pulp is made with the sufficient quantity of alcohol. Then the remaining quantity of alcohol is mixed with this pulp and kept it for 8 days. And at the end of 8th day, this juice is strained, or the extract is strained and filtered. And the mother tincture is thus obtained. Now the difference between class 2 and class 3 is, in class 2, we are moistened with the alcohol and the pulp and keep it for 2 to 3 days. And once it is properly mixed, then we have to extract the juice, then mix it with the remaining amount of alcohol and keep it for 8 days. Whereas in class 3, we are not keeping it for 3 days, but to the pulp itself, we are adding this alcohol and keeping it for 8 days. So that is the difference between class 2 and class 3. Now the drug strength or drug power is 1/6. And the fundamental rule here is Killa. Other drugs which is prepared with this class 3 is Arnica, Ethusa, Lilium Tick, Ruta, Ambrotanum, Podophyllum, Hypericum, Baptisia, and Gelsing. So these are the drugs which belongs to class 3. Now let us see the next class, that is class 4. Class 4, the dried plants or fresh or dried animals sources are considered. Now the drug vehicle ratio is 1:5. Residue maybe half. Drug power is 1/10. And here the drug substance and the vehicle, the alcohol is mixed. The drug substance in the form of powder. It is mixed with the 5 part of, to every 1 part of drug substance, 5 part of alcohol is taken and it is kept for 15 days. So first 3 classes, class 1, class 2 and class 3 is kept for 8 days. Whereas in class 4, it is kept for 15 days. At the end of 15th day, the extract or mother tincture is strained with the help of a linen cloth. Then after straining, it is filtered and thus the mother tincture is obtained. The drug power is 1/10. The fundamental rule in class 4 is Stapisagria, Spigelia and other drugs which is prepared with class 4 is epicarp, ledum, naxomica, ignitia, anacardium, coffea, cocculus, cantharis, epis, and hope. So these are the drugs which belongs to class 4. Now let us see the class and mostly chemical or mineral, soluble in water, drug strength 5A, it is 1:9, drug power is 1/10, 5B 1:99, drug power 1/100. And the fundamental rule in class 5A is natrum muriaticum. The other drugs are nitric acid, sulfuric acid, barytiamur, and ammonium carb. In 5B, fundamental rule is phosphoric acid. The other drugs are calibichromicum, borax, and antimony tart. Now class 7. Class 7, they are mostly chemicals or minerals origin which are soluble in alcohol. So 6A, class 6A, the drug molecule ratio is 1:9 and the drug power is 1/10. In class 6B, the drug molecule ratio is 1:99, drug power is 1/100. For class 6A, the fundamental rule is guaiacum. Other drugs are benzoic acid and camphor. In 6B, the fundamental rule is mercor, but the other drugs are iodum and creosote. Now class 7. Class 7, as I told, it is insoluble, hard, dry, and solid drug substances, but it is insoluble in alcohol and water. So it has to be grinded or triturated in sugar. So drug vehicle ratio in decimal scale, it is 1:9, whereas in centesimal scale, it is 1:99. The drug power also accordingly, in decimal scale 1/10, and centesimal scale, it is 1/100. The fundamental rule here is arsenicum album. The other drugs are cupramet, stannamet, sulfur, calicarb, graphitis, and cytisium. One more vegetable drug is allosocotrienol. Sorry, not allos, it is sepia. Sepia. In sepia, the dried inky juice is used. Allos belongs to class 4. Allos also, the dried drug substance is used, but it is soluble in alcohol and water mixture. So it belongs to class 4. Whereas sepia, it belongs to class 7. Now class 8, it is insoluble liquid, insoluble in alcohol or water, but it has to be triturated with a sugar. And mostly noisettes and snake venoms are prepared with the class 8. The drug vehicle ratio in decimal scale is 1:9. And drug vehicle ratio in centesimal scale is 1:99. The drug power in decimal scale is 1/10. Drug power in centesimal scale is 1/100. The fundamental rule in class 8 is petroleum, and other medicines which belongs to class 8 are lachesis, naja, lysins, and almost all the noisettes except sorinam. Sorinam is prepared with a class 6B. Now, one fundamental difference in ordinary trituration and class 8 trituration. Trituration done in class 8 and the the classical trituration is, in classical trituration, the process is divided into three parts of 20 minutes duration. So in these three stages of trituration, in the first stage, one part of, in decimal scale, one part of drug substance is mixed with three parts of sugar of milk. Then in the next stage, the next three parts added, and the third stage, the remaining three parts added. So totally 9 parts of sugar of milk is added with one part of drug substance. So this 9 part is equally divided into 3, and trituration is carried out in normal trituration. But in class 8 trituration, whole of the 9 part is used in the first stage of trituration itself. So one part is readily mixed with the 9 part of sugar of milk in the first stage of trituration itself. That is because we are using insoluble liquid. So if you use one part of this insoluble liquid drug substance with the three parts of sugar of milk, the sugar of milk will be stick onto the walls of mortar and water. So the trituration process may not be effective. So that is one reason the whole of the 9 part is added to the one part of insoluble liquid drug substance, and this trituration is carried out in the first stage itself. Then this process is continued in second and third stage of trituration. So that is the difference in a classical or normal trituration and trituration in class 8. Now coming to class 9, the nature of drug substance is insoluble and fresh drug substance is used from vegetable and animal sources with some residues. So here the drug vehicle ratio in decimal scale is 2:9, whereas drug power is 1/10. As I told, it may contain some amount of water or moisture which will be evaporating during the process of trituration or grinding. So considering that, we are taking two parts of drug substance in the beginning, but the drug containing only one part. We are assuming that this one part may be evaporated in the form of moisture or water. Now in centesimal scale, the same thing, two part of drug substance mixed with 99 parts of sugar. But the drug power will be 1/100. So here the fundamental rule is agaricus. Other drugs which belongs to class 9 are anacardium, blatta, etc. So this is about class 9. So with this, I am concluding this lecture on old method or classical method or Hahnemannian method of drug preparation. Thank you.